and they need some really big rings. They need some really nice things. Better be coming with no strings.
Good morning, once again, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back on the Lewis Basketball and Football Network. It is your boy Lewis, and I am back once again with an early morning heavy hit, another banger with yet another video. So in this video, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to quickly talk about Sean Livingston. As for some of you who know, and for those who don't know, Sean Livingston on his Instagram post just announced his retirement after playing 15 years in the NBA. And I just want to say congratulations on a very successful career. For those who remember watching Sean Livingston play, he was a very talented and athletic point guard at 6'7", who was getting comparisons to Scottie Pippen when he used to play. And I really thought that Sean Livingston was going to have a pretty good NBA career in terms of when he was on the come up. I really thought that if he was staying away from the injuries like early, well, the injury, I should say early, that I think he really would maybe something special. Like, we really don't know. And unfortunately, he suffered that horrific injury because remember, he was very skinny back in the day. And when he suffered that devastating knee injury, man, I just couldn't. I was in a loss for words. I was shocked. It was one of the first times that I had really seen a freak injury like his, because up to that point, I mean, I've seen guys get hurt, but not kind of at the level that he got hurt with that knee. And so I was kind of, I kind of teared up a bit, because it's like, I don't want to ever see players like get hurt at that kind of level. And I know he was in excruciating pain. And quite honestly, I really thought he was never going to be the same. I thought his NBA career would never happen. It would never happen. For him to come back and for him to be able to be a rotational player, you know, someone who was able to be a solid bench, take a solid bench role. Like when I saw him come back for Brooklyn and then sign with the Golden State Warriors and then be a part of three championship teams and be able to go to the NBA Finals 5 straight years on that very great Warriors franchise, is a testament to Sean Livingston, man, for him being able to persevere. When you look at it, when you look at an injury like that, that could have ended most careers. And he was able to come back and was a integral part and heavy contributor, big, huge contributor to those championship teams with the Golden State Warriors. People don't understand how important he was with him and Andre Iguodala coming off the bench. I mean, Sean Livingston, yo, very good mid-range shooter. And we know that the mid-range is a lost art in the NBA. And I'm really telling you that the mid-range really kind of sets you up, your abilities to score when you have a very good mid-range game. You know, he obviously didn't really need to rely on the three. He was a very good defender. Good rotational player, was a very good playmaker. And people don't understand this, yo. He had very good playmaking skills when he first came in. And I was like, yo, this guy has the potential to be really something special. Like, he had very, very good playmaking ability. It's just unfortunate that the knee injury took, you know, a good amount of years of his career. But for him to be able to play 15 years after, you know, the injury, something special, man. Something special. And I appreciate, you know, what he was able to bring for the NBA. You root for guys like that. And the fact that he was able to go out a three-time NBA champion is even more so. How many great players, you know, never got to win that big one, even reach the big dance and didn't get a chance to win one? And Sean Livingston is one of those that can say that I'm a three-time champion, like not just an NBA champion, but a three-time champion. Maybe as a role player, but won 3 championships and was a huge contributor. You know, a big piece of those championship teams. And shout out to the Golden State Warriors, because they built their team from the ground up, okay? They were a laughingstock for years. And people forget that in 2007, when this team won those 42 games, when they looked like they were going to miss the playoffs, and this was under head coach Don Nelson, they get the players they get. You got Al Harrington with Jay Rich and Steven Jackson with Baron Davis. You know, with those guys, the We Believe and Matt Barnes, the We Believe Golden State Warriors, Andres Biedrins, you know, I remember that team. Kalena Azubuike, I remember that team very well. Monte Ellis. Like, what people need to understand is, you know, the very next year that they won 48 games, they were the 9th seed and failed to make the playoffs. That's how difficult the West was in 2008 and in 2010. That's crazy, right? And so the Warriors after that, they were just they were a laughing stock for, you know, a good number of years. They started to come to prominence in 2013. Then people looked like, well, maybe it was a 1-year fluke and they'll go back to missing the playoffs again. What happens? They make the playoffs again and win more games. Then under Steve Kerr, and then against, you know, getting players here and there. Look, they get Bogut in 2013. They get Iguodala in 2014. They sign Livingston in the offseason of 2014. They get Leandro Barbosa. You know, they have David Lee and Steph Curry rising to superstar prominence, man. Klay Thompson gets into the starting lineup. Draymond Green gets into the starting lineup. You know, after those guys being drafted and these idiotic fanboys who try to... Listen, the Warriors are a great team, but it's like you see how they try to do this to fit the narrative for LeBron. That's why I keep telling you that, listen, they're a great team with role players that played the system very well, okay? And their best player, you know, is the point guard in Steph Curry. But getting back to Sean Livingston, you know, he had a great NBA career, you know, in order to be able to follow, you know, what possibly would have never happened. You know, because all of this could have been gone with that devastating knee injury. But he comes back and was able to play 15 years. And look, he retired at 34. He can still play. But he can still play, to be honest with you. And I think he could definitely help a team out that's trying to get into championship contention. But we started to kind of see a little bit of deterioration with Sean Livingston. And he was getting injured a little bit as well. So I'm guessing that's why he's retiring. But with all due respect, Sean Livingston, man, you get the biggest salute. I salute to you, brother, on a great career. And I wish you the best of luck in what you do, life after basketball. I definitely would like to see you back in the NBA as an analyst, but because I think you could bring great insight to the game. And, you know, debunk narratives, because you know that the media is going to want to love to bring you, when I look at guys like Nick Wright and Chris Carter and Shannon Sharpe and Colin Cowherd, they're going to look at you and Jason McIntyre, what a clown he is. But they're going to want to bring you to try to, you know, put narratives on the Golden State Warriors and how bad the locker room was, especially when it comes to Kevin Durant and he's no longer there. But with all that being said, man, congratulations. I'm proud for the fact that you had a great career. And like I said, man, stay blessed. You know, enjoy your family, enjoy the rest of your career. Life after basketball, you know, excited was to see to bring that for you. So much respect to you. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is your boy Lewis back with another one. I will be back with another video, and you already know the deal as always. Live, laugh, love. Thank you for watching the video. You know, I had to do this for my man Kid Glory because he was on my live stream saying, could I play that Bow Wow outro since I'm a fool for this one. So since I'm a fool for this one, I'm a fool for this one. Play that outro, play that banger for my man Kid Glory, man.
As I sit back, relax, get my hair cornrowed, okay. Thinking about these little honeys that I wanna know, oh. Ray and Simone, kinda grown, holla back. Whoa. I wanna go one-on-one with Kyler Pratt. Woo. Picture that, what would a mom say? Kiss the lines and turn it into Beyonce. Cause I'm a Mac, no trivia to that. Nivea cleaning my throwbacks at Laundry Max. And I'm a Gia, yeah. Every time I see her, squeeze 3LW up in my two-seater. And Christina Milian is the bomb. As she move her body like a snake. My, oh, Jennifer Freeman got kicked from the crib. She was talking about some wife and kids. Making good, if I could, then I would. Whoa. You say I won't, but I really think I should. Show my rims to the Austin twins. Yo, they looked at each other and they both hopped in. Cause I'm a pimp. Whoa. I feed some lobster shrimp. Well, you know, this is the rhyme. I don't mean no offense. Let's go.